Welcome to Yun Tuition. I am Yun. Let's continue discussing general knowledge about surface air pressure in meteorology. It is now clear that the surface air pressure is essential for stabilizing the surface temperature everywhere. Otherwise, there would never have been our biosphere. Today, I'm going to discuss a different but more realistic description of weather in relation to surface air pressure. This may well be an unexpected shock for meteorologists in general and weather reporters in particular. So, are you ready? Let's go and have fun. We were used to watch weather forecasts at the end of the daily TV news, presented by a well-dressed weatherman such as Edwin Maher, who eventually worked for the CCTV in communist China. A weather map, often called as synoptic chart, is made by a number of irregular loops called isobars, meaning any locations on the same isobar curve should have the same surface air pressure. Two capital letters are often used in a weather map, H and L, which represent, according to many a meteorology textbook, local maximum and local minimum pressures, respectively, presumably very close to the surface. By overlaying the surface temperature, it is clear that the places with L are relatively hotter than their surrounding areas, whereas the places with H are relatively colder than their surrounding regions, although the isobars and isotherms are not always in phase. Similar to global mean surface temperature, or GMST, it is impossible to obtain global mean surface pressure. Instead, a mean sea level pressure, or MSLP for short, is frequently used for a short period of time. That's why those isobar curves in the weather map are time dependent and must be updated every hour. This is understandable as weather forecasts are almost impossible without using such time dependent isobars. Why? Because it is generally accepted that air currents, moist or dry, cold or hot, are initially driven by pressure gradient forces, or PGF for short. However, as discussed in my previous talk, the surface air pressure would be a constant if the total mass of air molecules in a vertical unit column above the surface is fixed. That's the basis for my new description for weather. Of course, the atmosphere is a dynamic system. Therefore, fluctuations in the vertical column mass are inevitable, given the general circulation. That may affect the local air pressure for sure. But it seems no quantitative justification can be easily found. Here, I would like to draw your attention to an important mechanism for weather change that has been omitted in many a meteorology textbook, namely air diffusion caused by air density gradient without any PGF, the force arising from pressure difference in horizontal directions near the surface of the Earth. Bear in mind, I'm not going to talk about the vertical pressure gradient due to gravity. Indeed, the air pressure 10 meters above the ground is just about 1 hectopascal or hectopascal weaker compared with the mean surface air pressure 1013 hectopascal. So it is reasonable to treat the thermodynamical process in the atmosphere near the surface as isobaric, meaning constant pressure. Consider a small area near the surface, such as a football ground. According to ideal gas law, the product of the air temperature near the surface and the air density must be a constant if air pressure is fixed, as shown in this diagram. To be exact, the dependence of air density on surface temperature is reciprocal. That's to say, If air pressure is fixed, the air density near the surface would decrease as the local surface temperature increases. Here, let's focus on the initial local response to the change of the surface temperature so that we can still rely on the gas law. Perhaps you may ask, how could you explain weather change without the drivers due to air pressure differences? Simple, because whenever air density distribution is not uniform, air currents can be formed due to diffusion processes without PGF, from higher air density regions to lower air density areas, as shown in this CFD or computational fluid dynamics simulation for air flows in a hole due to air diffusion. As air currents diffuse near the surface, forces show up, including Coriolis, frictional, and centrifugal, in the same principle as for the air current driven by PGF. Not a big deal. In fact, we can still use those weather maps, provided the capital letter H and L now represent high air density and low air density respectively, whilst the irregular loops of traditionally called isobar should be called as equal density curves. Ideally, to evaluate my new proposal, air density should be directly measured by simultaneously measuring the air pressure and air temperature at each position. If so, it is expected that the measured air pressure be a constant near the surface, irrespective of the local surface temperatures. Alternatively, air density can be determined by measuring sound speed, which depends on both air density and air temperature. In fact, this table shows how the three dependent variables are determined, as used in this diagram. To summarize briefly, one, it is proposed that weather change near the surface can be approximated as an isobar process in which the product of air density and the local surface temperature remains as a constant, whilst air pressure is fixed. Two, in doing so, the traditionally called isobar loops in weather maps, known as synoptic charts, now represent equal density curves. As you can see, my route to this conclusion is by no means straightforward, as I first argued that the air density near the surface might be a constant in my first talk on this subject. Now, it is demonstrated here that the air density near the surface can be treated as a prime variable for weather forecasts. Make your comments, please, no matter whether you agree or disagree. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation. See you next time.